Should women change their house and surname after their marriage?
I guess yes, because like it's means matlab mom dad se to unka bas bidai ho jati hai, to I guess ho jata hai, to unko separate rehna padta hi hai.
क्योंकि वो पहले से ही प्रथा चालू है तो वो करना चाहिए ऐसे मुझे लगता है.
आई डोंट थिंक सो, बट एंसेस्टर्स से ये फॉलो होता आ रहा है तो वी शुड नॉट मतलब वी शुड नॉट एलिमिनेट दिस थिंग कम्प्लीटली.
नॉट नेसेसरी, बट एज इट्स बीन अ रिचुअल और काइंड ऑफ यू नो it has been passed from our ancestors and from many ages, so now it has been common.
Because the very basic reason for is that women should change their house, because it's going on from such a long time, itne time se sab chal raha hai, so it's like you have to go with the flow. Now if I say I won't change, I'll stay in a living relationship, then it will be against the society. I want to live in the society, I'll have to follow that. So changing the house is okay with me, but with the surname thing I won't do.
This is called the bandwagon fallacy. Everyone is doing it, so it must be right. We have been doing it for centuries, so it must be right. This is not a valid enough argument. Just because everyone has been doing something for centuries does not make it right. There was a time when the majority of the people used to think the practice of sati was right. Or there was a time when most people thought there was nothing wrong with slavery or untouchability. There was even a time when the majority of the people were against the education of women, because these practices were carried on from generation to generation. But now when we look back, we know how wrong we were. So, just because everyone has been doing something for centuries does not necessarily make it right.
It really depends on the personal choice. If they want, they can change, and there should be freedom for them to do that.
House is it is compulsory, because boys marry because of that only, that after marriage the girl will keep his mother and dad safe or take care of them. So girl have to say, change her house. Surname, it is not compulsory. From first only she is being with the permanent surname from her family, so she should join her surname with his husband's surname.
See, personally I feel it's a right of a woman to change her house after the marriage, because I feel the woman handles a man a lot. So the man is the only person who's I think a woman should change her house. She should be now she should go to somebody else's house to handle the responsibilities, and they make it together. It's like part.
I think it depends on the woman. If she wants to change her surname, it's okay. Also about the house, it's better if both of the husband and the wife both are independent, so they live in a separate house. That would be the best option.
घर देखो, सीन तो ऐसा है ना, अगर लड़की की शादी हो गई ना, वो अपना सरनेम बीच में डालती है। घर हाँ चेंज तो होना चाहिए ना वहाँ के. अच्छे तो उसके मम्मी को कौन संभालेगा, उसके मॉम डैड को कौन संभालेगा? अगर शादी करके जाएगी उसके घर पे तो अपने बंदा क्यों शादी करता है? क्यों अपने मॉम डैड को संभाले? हाँ क्यों शादी करता है? क्योंकि अपने मॉम डैड को ले वो लड़की संभाले, इसलिए वो घर चेंज करके जाती है. फिर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
See, I think regarding changing the house, so now this is a thing in which usually nowadays both are changing houses. Now the time has come in which even the male, and the female, when they get married, they probably buy another new house, or at least that is their dream.
I don't think women should actually change the house and surname. See, it's not wrong to move to somebody's house. But again, a society right now is such that will not accept the guy living at the women's house. So it's all because of the society. Otherwise, I think there's no harm in doing that. So wherever you're comfortable, I think it's fine. You go stay there.
But it can also be possible that 6 months the guy lives in the woman's house and 6 months the woman lives with the
That would be a little difficult because each time you need to move, pack, unpack, and move. Like, or rather than I would suggest, just go live separately.
Do you think marriage is necessary and why?
No, not at all. I mean, if you're happy with a live-in relationship or if you're happy being independent, you should totally do it. I would.
No, I really don't think so. Marriage is necessary. You can actually live happily single or even in live-in or like whatever you want to.
Marriage, yes, it is. It is.
A few things which separate us from animals. Separate humans from animals. And so the marriage is, I think, is one. So definitely if we don't, you know, there are still communities, you know, possibly who are living without marriage. So they are more like animals.
I don't think marriage is necessary. People do need companions, I feel.
Nahi. If a single woman can handle her life of her own, so why she should marry? उसके भी तो मॉम डैड होते हैं, उसको भी तो संभालना रहता है मॉम डैड को.
I don't think marriage should be compulsory. It should be the individual's choice. I think it's a social construct, and it should not be compulsory.
If you look at the side of future planning and family planning, I think it is necessary, but it's not something that without which you can't live. I don't think so. It's like why it depends person to person.
Why can't you just live together? Why do you need a legal certificate?
Acha, okay. So basically even legal certificate is something which can bound two people, whereas if they don't have any legal certificate, then they can leave each other anytime. So if they have something, some foundations or like some certificates on them, though, they will at least be little bit bothered that
but
it can affect us.
Leave each other, then what? They could be
no, but because we all are human, no, we all make decisions so quick. So sometimes we realize after making it. So if we are bounded with some kind of legal foundations, we cannot take the decision so quickly, right?
Which house do you think belongs to the woman? The house before her marriage or the house after the marriage?
Well, that's an interesting question. I think wherever you find your loved ones is your house, be it a man's or a woman's house, perception of a house.
I really don't think so. I can define that, but yeah, where the woman honestly feels comfortable and safe, and I think where she knows, okay, that's her place, like
where she feels the most herself. Okay. House that doesn't involve her being in the chains of patriarchy.
Which house belongs to the woman, do you think?
Her husband's house. No, it's the husband's house, no? Because when she was at her parents' house, then she must have not given that much effort to make that as a house, which her mother must have given. Now when she's going to somebody's house, she's the person who's making it a home, right?
Quality means equal rights for both the genders. All the stereotypes, I think they should first, we should try and make them go away. And
so in which way do you think it is not equal, right?
I guess equal pay in jobs and all. I've heard that even in the film industry and all, the actresses get paid less even though their work is as much as the actors. So yeah, that's one example.
What I believe is that boys and girls are treated differently at a very young age. Not maybe in the household that I grew up, but these differences come from a very basic background where if a poor household does not have food and there's only one glass, I'm just giving an example, one glass of milk left, and there's a little boy and a little girl, the boy will get the milk. That creates a bias in the heads of those little children as well. They grow up to be individuals who are growing in a mentality where it's not their fault, but it has been propagated at a young age. This shows in pay scale. This shows when women are paid versus when men are paid, not just in normal corporate world, but in sports, like we know, or in the entertainment industry as well. So these little things contribute to the gender inequality.
do you think that we address God as a he and like we generally say God has no gender, but we generally address as a he? We assume that God is a man. Do you think that that would be the cause of inequality?
I don't think that really. Now that you say, maybe sometimes it does happen that when we add, when we write God, we address it him as a male. But there are many female strong goddesses in our Indian culture. Like for example, goddess Durga is a very strong figure in the Hindu gods. So I'm not really sure if that adds, but maybe it can be because there is a mentality, so it's our tendency to address.
We end the segment with a quote from Laurel Thatcher Ulrich: obedient women rarely make history. What do you think about these questions? Write to us in the comments below. You can join more of such discussions by joining the Freethinkers Colloquy group on Facebook. If you wish to remain updated with more of our videos, make sure you don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.